My name is Thomas Foster, and this is a short tutorial, a quick start for the Pygmets of Arturia. Arturia is a French hardware and software synthesizer company, and they've made a really great job with Pygmets. Most of all, it convinces me with a completely new concept for a user interface in which the movements of the controllers are displayed graphically. But let's start from the beginning. When we open Pygmets the first time, it should look like this. Here we have the engine. Here we can control our oscillators or wavetables. Here we have two filters. And the most important thing that I really love is the controller bar. Here we see the controllers coming from the keyboard, like the velocity, the aftertouch, the modulation wheel, but also the envelopes, the LFOs, the functions, they are really great, and the random and the combinate, where we can combine different modulators. Yeah, and then we have other pages, like beside the synth page, there is a FX page with the effects and a sequencer page where we have the sequencer and the arpeggiator. But if we really would like to start from the beginning, let's take a look how we load a sound. Here on the top, we can click on the name of the synthesizer and we get a list of all sounds by sorted by alphabet. That's not so useful, I would say. I prefer much more when we click here on all types. We can load a bass if we go to the bass menu, or a sequence if we go to the sequence menu. Let's load the, for example, the funny arpeggiators. Really funny. Or we go to be arpeggiated. Really nice. But even better is the browser. If we click here, like the books in a store, we can say, I would like to have a bass, and I would like to sound the bass aggressive. And now we can double click on the sounds here. Let's try another one. We want to have some keys, and they should sound digital. The only one we have is the hardcore clef. But now let's take a look, how is it if I want to program a sound from the scratch. The first thing we're gonna do, we click here where it says now filter to get this menus, go to template, default. Now we have the really default song and it sounds like a sinus. We have two engines, the engine 1 and the engine 2. In the engine 1, we can go to analog, looks like this, and to wavetable. And it's exactly the same for the engine 2, wavetable and analog. Let's stay at engine 1 and go to analog. Here we have three oscillators. And here we can choose between the sinus, the triangle, the sawtooth, and the square. So let's take the sinus for the first oscillator. That's the volume here of the oscillator 1. Let's open up the volume of oscillator 2. And here we maybe take the square. And we can go up for 1 octave. And on 3, we'd also put in some volume and go to the sawtooth. We also could add a little bit of noise. And now we go to engine number 2 and choose there the wavetable. We put it on here with this button and we click on this button to just hear engine number 2. And here we also have the sinus and it goes directly into the triangle, in the sawtooth, and the square. And we can move or morph between these four. But we also can have much complexer ones. If we click here on basic waveforms, we can go to natural, for example, and choose the waveform of vocal formants. Or we go to a synthesizer like this one here. And now we can mix this with engine number one. To form a little bit more our sound, means to make it more interesting, we can use here some frequency modulation, phase modulation, phase distortion. Just try what is happening. It's very easy. What we also can do to make the sound really fat is to use more voices. In unison, we have now one voice, but we can go up to 8 voices and detune them a little bit. If we go now to the right, we find our filter. We can add some resonance. We can choose other filters like high pass, band pass filter. And now let's take a look to our modulation bar here. Let's start with the LFO. So I click on LFO and here I see my 3 LFOs. I click now here on LFO 1. And now it says drag knob contours to create or edit a modulation routing. So we drop down the cutoff like this. And now we place the mouse on the ring of the filter. You see how the mouse symbol is changing, right? And now we go up and now we see how the LFO is moving our filter. And it can move many things. For example, the position of our wavetable. Here you can change the tempo of your LFO. And you can change the waveform. Very nice. Let's delete this again and take a look to the envelope. The first envelope is doing the volume. We go here to envelopes and here we see envelope 1. We have an attack. We have the decay, the sustain, and the release, that is what is happening when you release the key. But now let's use the envelope 2 to control the filter. So I click on envelope 2. I could again here drop, move this ring to make this happening. The other way to make this happen, let's go out here. If we go to the filter, we find this plus here. Again, you move the mouse over the filter, cut off. Here you see the plus. You click on the plus and now you can say envelope 2 should control the filter. And you see how it's moving immediately if I press a key, and I can make this slower by changing the decay time. Very nice. But let's reset also this one. And take a look to the functions. Let's say function 1 should control our filter and maybe also the tune of engine 1 and engine 2. All right, and now we can add points simply by clicking here. And we can make a curve. You can make up to 7 points. Isn't that cool? Oh, I love it. Random, you can randomize some modulations. You can combine the LFOs and the envelopes. So you can have a lot of fun. But I would like to take a look with you to the FX and the sequencer page. So the whole time we were working on the synth page. Now let's load another song. Maybe we go here to keys and load the funky backing. Bring in some more high frequencies. Let's go to the FX page. Here you can add 3 effects. 1 as a bass and 3 with a send and return. Let's go to delay. Let's change a little bit the tempo of the delay. Let's go to the reverb. And we continue with the sequencer. There is a sequencer in the arpeggiator. What is the difference? Let's take a look to arpeggiator. Now I can press two notes and it's always changing between these two notes. If I go to sequencer, I can draw the melody, but if I play more than one note, it just plays this one note. So I play now two notes. You just hear one note, but you can change the melody here. With this button here, you always can reset the sound.
Beside the pitch, we have the possibility to change the octave.
One octave up, two octave up. We can change the velocity. The gate length, that's the length of the note. And I like very much the slide. Let's make the third note one octave higher and make the gate long, and here we activate the slide. That's very nice. With trigger proper, we can randomize the note. Does it play or not? Let's do the following. On every second note, we go down a little bit. So this note is play for 100%, this just for 28. So let's go down here and here and here. But there's also a nice randomizer. So we can say we want to randomize the pitch. Let's go to 100%. And now let's activate the random for one bar. Randomize one bar. And now you see every bar, it's changing. Let's also change the octave, the velocity, gate, slide. The Pigmats of Arturia is a really great VST plugin. I especially love the graphical representation of the controller. If you have any questions about this video or about Pigmats, just drop it in the comments below. In order not to miss any of my episodes, please subscribe to my channel Thomas Foster Music Production. My name is Thomas Foster, and if you like producing music, then you probably need regular audio loops. So good sounding drum loops, percussion, guitar, vocal, and many other samples. And there is a new exciting webpage I'm involved in developing, Mutant.com. Mutant is a search engine for audio loops and samples. The stuff sounds really great and is well produced and mastered. The incredible thing is that although Mutant actually sees itself as a web shop, at the moment almost all sounds are free. You do not have to enter an email address, just go to Mutant.com, search for the desired audio file and click download. And it's really fun to work with. At that point, I say thank you for being there. Always stay creative. Cheers.